Hey, good morning. You're on with Big J, and you know what time it is. It's time to talk sports, news, and information. We pray that everyone is having a great morning, and your day is starting off the right way, and things are great for you and your family. We just hope that you are encouraged to take further steps to become who you know you are to be. So we want to thank you again for tuning in with Big J. Let's talk. If you have not done so yet, please subscribe to our channel. Make sure that you hit that red subscribe button. Also, go over to your right and hit the bell so you'll be notified when we upload new content. Also, go down and smash that like button. After you smash that like button, if the content is favorable or conducive, do us a favor and leave a comment. We do appreciate you, for you are amazing. You are the asset and never a liability. We can't do this without you, so we salute you this morning. As you can see on the screen, it's early morning, got my coffee up, did my research a couple of hours. What would be my first topic today? And a lot of people might consider this as negative, but it is not. We often hear on YouTube individuals talking about women and men and stance that we should take and who is the stronger of the two. Well, let me help you out with something from those who don't understand from a scriptural perspective, is that the Bible says at the head of Jesus is God, and at the head of man is Jesus, and at the head of woman is man. But that does not mean that woman is to be under a man or get under a man's burden. It simply means, comes from the Greek word to get under or to support the narrative from the top, which is God. All right. So man has no narrative without God, whereby if a man does not have a narrative, then the woman does not have a narrative. But I didn't mean to go there, but I want to say this. This young lady is standing alone, and she's standing with a burden on her shoulder. And people say, well, BJ, why are you making a big deal out of Gwen Berry, man? Man, we're in the 21st. Man, it's 2021. Yeah, true. Exactly. But the things that she's standing for are the negative things that we hear on YouTube with African-American people going back and forth with each other. And I understand that the dialogue causes controversy. And where there's controversies, there are bags. There's economics. I definitely understand that. But while everybody's getting a million subscribers and super chats and the rest of this, this young lady is standing out here by herself. And I respect her. And let me tell you why I respect her. Because she said, listen, you're going to give me my award, but at the same time you're giving me my award, you're going to play the anthem that talks about black people being slaves and death. She said, for me, that is condescending, and it actually offends me that you would do that. Then there was an Arkansas governor that said, if you don't like it, well, just get off the team, ma'am. Well, here's the reality. You're telling me we've just went back 400 years. And if I don't like what you're doing to me and saying to me, I could just get off the team when I've earned the right to wear this uniform. I've earned the right to stand and support America through the Olympics. But you're going to tell me I could just get off the team? And this is what I'm saying, brothers. We're all calling each other the N-word and other things superfluous. And we don't you think that America knows that we are not identified by strength, but we are identified by tearing each other down? So when they look at it and she goes out there and she stands and she takes the position, she's frowned upon and looked down upon, yet she's representing this country. Don't you think the masses listens to YouTube and they make fun of our dialogues and some of the other content? And they say, they're going to pay us for it because, like we've always done, we made them happy. Blackface. Not Gwen Berry. Not at all. She's changed to represent who and what she is. And you got to respect her. I'm sorry. And I'm not, like I said today, I'm not coming on to be funny, to be jovial, to any. I'm coming on because there has to be a representative say enough is enough. Forget the bags for a minute. Enough is enough. And if we don't, we talk about Black Lives Matter. So are we only going to wait until someone is shot? Then that's when we're going to go out and protest? Are we only going to wait to where there's a George Floyd situation to where we're going to protest? Or are we going to stand up, get on these channels, get on this platform, and say enough is enough, no more? There something has to happen. I don't believe that God gave some of us a platform and an outlet just for ourselves. We are to be spokesmen for a greater people without a leadership or a head. But we're so busy tearing each other down, it's comical. And I have to check myself at times too, because I find myself doing the same thing. I am in no way saying that the only lives that matter are Black lives. All lives matter. But for someone to play such a racist segment of a song when someone just competed for the country that they live in and are a part of, this is why, if you look at the thumbnail, she turned her back. Now, wait a minute. Why would that Arkansas governor say that? They turned their back on her when they played the song. It's the same thing, isn't it? Are the principles changed? Or are they the same thing? They turned their back on her. So what did she do? She turned their back on the words to that song, not on America. Get it right, people. She did not turn her back on America because she competed for America. She turned her back to that song to where it spoke of slaves and death. What was she supposed to do? Stand up there and say, woo-hoo, they doing that nigga song again. Come on. We got to get it or we're never going to get it. All right, there's articles all over America this morning. She's being just totally looked down upon. If you can today and you're on your channel, just say, shout out Gwen Berry. You don't got to go into it, but just shout her out. You understand? Sometimes these people go on YouTube and they'll see this. Let her know, hey, you know what? Man, somebody was thinking about you, Gwen. Great job. We only have 3,000, almost 3,000 subs. So we don't have that large of a platform, but we do have a podcast, which I hope somebody gives this to her so she hears it. Great job, Gwen. Big J, let's talk. We stand with you, because no one should have to be go through those things and be demeaned like you just don't matter, like you're just an athlete who represents us like they did before. I'm not going to say any names, and we're going to use you. Yes, I am Jesse Owens. Yes, I am. Are we still in an era? Haven't we come a long way? Oh, I get it. I get it. 98% of you kill each other, but when 2% of us kill you, it's a problem. Oh, I get it. Oh, when I go on YouTube, all I hear are Black men calling each other nigga. Oh, I get it. But yet you want us to respect you? Nah. So if you don't like the team, Miss Berry, get off of it, because we're going to play the song. When do we rise up and say, yes, we love the country. Yes, we thank God for being here. Yes, this is our home. Yes, we help build America. But at the same time, stop with the racist comments, the racist songs, and the racist statements. Stop already. Enough is enough. We stand with our sisters and our brothers, shoulder to shoulder, who built this country and who are part of this great empire. So then why should we have to be reduced when it comes to certain things? Because we are powerful. Let the power fall and let it rain. You know what? I want to say thank you for being on with Big J this morning. We really appreciate you. You are amazing. I'm telling you again, if it was not for you, we would not be on here. It's not, we're not getting bags, we don't get super chats, we don't get any of that. But what we do, we just want to make this business work so we can keep it going, because we don't only enjoy it, we love it. Because when you can bring value to a person's day when it's starting, I think that's one of the best things in the world. And I don't want to have to be a comedian to do it. That's just me. I just want to bring you the truth based on a proper narrative which is conducive for your hearing and understanding. So you know what I'm going to say right here, if you have not done it yet. And again, I'm not talking about Miss Berry disrespecting the flag, disrespecting the country. All I'm saying is she should have been allowed to turn her back on that song and put her hand on her hip. And she did. You go, Miss Berry. You know, because she had that right. So again, I want to thank you for tuning in with Big J. Let's talk. Do us a favor. If you have not subscribed to us yet, now is the time and that opportunity. I know you're sitting there. I know you're thinking about it. Just go ahead and click it. And then go over to the bell and hit the bell so you'll be notified when we upload content. And we try to make it as conducive as possible. If it's not, then you can let us know in the comment section how you feel. Leave a comment. Do me a favor. I don't usually ask for anything, but I'm going to ask you to smash that like button. All right? YouTube likes the algorithm. So again, we do appreciate you. And you know what I'm going to say at this time. Be the best, and the best you will become. You've been on with Big J. Have a blessed day.